Hello friends, in today's class we will see about parallel lines and transversal. Now what is parallel lines? Parallel lines are straight lines that never meet. You would all know what do you mean by parallel lines. Now when a transversal line cuts two parallel lines, so given line L and M that is parallel to each other and it is cut by a line P which is called as the transversal line. When such a thing happens, what are the properties between the angles we will see. Corresponding angles are equal. Now what are the corresponding angles? Angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles, that is they lie on the same side of the transversal, okay. And angle 2 and angle 6 are equal. Angle 3 and angle 7 are equal and angle 4 and angle 8 is equal, okay. So they are called corresponding angles. You all know what is corresponding angles? 1 and 5, 2 and 6, 3 and 7, 4 and 8, okay. One more property is that the pair of alternate interior angles are equal. Now what do you mean by alternate interior angles? Now angle 3 and angle 6 are alternate angles and they are also interior angles. They lie opposite to each other but they are inside, okay. So they are called the alternate interior angles. So alternate interior angles are equal. If you see, it is just like forming an Z, okay. 3 and 6 are equal. Similarly, 4 and 5 are equal. They are the alternate interior angles. Similarly, pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. That is, these are the pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. They both lie to the left of the transversal. So they are both supplementary. What do you mean by supplementary? When you add 3 and 5, I will get 180 degrees. Similarly, when I add 4 and 6, I will get 180 degrees because they lie on the same side of the transversal are interior angles that lie on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. Now let us solve some problems so that you will understand this concept even better. Okay. In the given figure, if the line AB is parallel to CD, then the angle APQ is equal to 50 degrees. This angle is 50 degrees and angle PRD is 130 degrees. Then find this angle, that is PQPR. Okay. So this angle you have to find. Okay. Now we know that line AB is parallel to line CD and PR is a transversal. So when a transversal cuts through a pair of lines, parallel lines, what happens? We all know that. We know the properties, isn't it? So we get that angle BPR. What is BPR? BPR, angle BPR plus PRD, this angle, angle BPR plus PRD is equals to 180 degrees. We all know that angle BPR, this angle and this angle, because they are nothing but interior angles and they lie on the same side of the transversal. Pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal lines are supplementary. So both these angles are supplementary. So angle BPR plus PRD is equals to 180 degrees. Angle BPR plus what is PRD? PRD is 130 degrees. So we get angle BPR is equals to 50 degrees. Now we know one more property, that if all these three angles are added, then what we'll get? We'll get 180 degrees. That is angle APQ plus QPR plus RPB. If all these three angles are added up, I'll get 180 degrees. I know that angle APQ is equals to 50 degrees plus QPR plus RPB. Now, QPR I will take my 50 to the other side. And what is RPB? RPB is also 50 degrees, which we got from the previous side. So angle QPR is equals to 180 minus 100 degrees, which is equals to 80 degrees. This is 50 degrees and this is also 50 degrees. So we have to find this. 50 plus 50 is 100. That subtracted from 180 is 80 degrees. I hope you understood how we got the answer to this problem. We will now see another problem. In this given figure, POR is a line. In this given figure, POR is a line. Find A. Now, POR is a straight line. I am given two angles in terms of A. So, the sum of the angles forming the linear pair is 180 degrees. Now, this is a line and you have the straight line and there are two angles. So, they will be supplementary to each other. They form a linear pair. So, the sum is 180 degrees. So, when I add both the angles, that is POQ plus QOR, I get 180 degrees. That is 3A plus 5 plus 2A minus 25. When I solve this equation, I get 5A minus 25 plus 5 is equals to 180 degrees, or 5A is equals to 200, or A is equals to 40 degrees. This is how I solve this problem. I hope you got it. That is, I added both these things, equated it to 180 degrees. When we solve this further, we get A equals to 40 degrees. Okay. Now, let us see another problem from this lines and angles. In this given figure, PA is parallel to BC, which is parallel to DT, and AB is parallel to DC. Find the values of A and B. Now we are given one line, that is PA, another line BC, which is parallel, and DT. All these three lines are parallel to each other and AB is parallel to DC. Okay. Now it is given that PA is parallel to BC. And AB is the transversal. So this angle PAB will be equal to ABC, isn't it? Because they are alternate interior angles, and since these two lines are parallel, they both are equal. So A will be equal to this angle, which is 50 degrees. I hope you got it. Similarly, if AB is parallel to DC, and BC is the transversal. Say this, if AB is parallel to DC, then BC is the transversal. What do we get? Angle ABC plus angle DCB will be, what is it? They will be 180 degrees. Okay. That is A plus DCB. A plus this angle and this angle are supplementary, which is equals to 180 degrees. When we solve this problem further, we get DCB equals to 180 minus A, which is equals to 180 minus 50 degrees, which is equals to 130 degrees. Because what is B? B and this angle we got here is, they are also alternate interior angles. Okay. This 130 degrees which I got here, they are alternate interior angles. So, B is equals to 130 degrees. I hope all of you understood this. Thank you, friends.